Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to Asgard, and welcome back to Qantas. I hope everyone's having a great day. So since last episode, you'll notice immediately there's somewhat of a ceiling here. What this is going to be, this is the bottom section. There's going to be an upper part here too. But this is basically the part that you're going to see if you're looking up. And I'm going to go through and start doing like some design with, I think, some kind of a black-ish block, I think. Possibly a basalt or maybe even a hardened stone. I don't know. I'm still debating on the color that I want to use, or if I want to go with something more like a blue, which is very possible as well. But I'm going to go through here and do a design and stuff so that if you're looking down there, you can look up and you'll see that design on this ceiling section. But this part here is going to stay open. Because up at the top of this temple, a little ways above this floor, is going to be a big, kind of like arched ceiling with designs and stuff in that. So I wanted to leave, a bit of that open while still having these upper floors where you can kind of look down. And then this section up here, once I get our living wood setup going, this is all going to be dream wood and stuff. And then it's going to have like a border block as well. And then over here to cross this gap, I'm going to set up living wood avatars, and I'm going to bring just a little bit of mana up here, and then these living wood avatars are going to have Bifrost rods. So then if you I'm thinking I'll have probably three on each side, and so then if you run across, it's going to be a rainbow bridge that builds right under your feet as you run. So you'll just be able to like cross between these these different platforms from one side of the building to the other. And I think it'll be a cool way to have kind of a bridge. It's not always there, so if you're down here and you're looking up, it's not going to be like kind of, in the way and all of that. It's just going to be there whenever you need it. Are you mad? Are you a little bit angry? Ha. There you go. All right, I don't really want that. Anyways, I did move our storage drawers over here, because I want this so that you can kind of walk through here, and instead of having them right here, which this area won't necessarily be accessible, I put them here so that we can kind of just move between and have access to these. But anyways, today I want to continue working on our cobble works. So the next steps are, of course, I want gravel being produced, I want sand being produced, I want clay, I want glass. Those are the four major things. Now, later on, plus, I don't know if we'll get to it this episode, but we are going to automate all the taiga stone as well. Or not taiga, the metamorphic stone. I do want that automated so that if we need it, we've got access to it. But the clay, the sand, the glass, the gravel, those are my primary concerns right now because I need glass, and I don't really want to have to go cook up the little bit of sand I have to try to make some glass to work on windows, because these windows actually do take quite a bit of glass. And especially when I'm coloring and doing all that stuff, it takes a little bit. But you'll notice here, I mean, we have an absolute ton of stuff. We've got 305 cobblestone, 115 living rock, and 263 stone, and that's in stacks, by the way. I don't even count individual ones anymore. But anyways, also in addition, I did go ahead and I enchanted our Terra Shatterer, because I was like, well, before long we'll enchant with mana and have our, Batania enchanting going and all that good stuff. But for now, I just wanted something on my Terra Shatterer. And let's just say it's OP. We got Fortune 3, Efficiency 5, XP Boost 3, Auto Smelt, and Unbreaking 3 on the Terra Shatterer. Plus, it's an S rank, so right now it mines a 7x7 area. It is absolutely ridiculous. And the fact that it has Fortune 3 and Auto Smelt is kind of strange. Like for example, if I mine coal, of course that gives me bottles of creosote. But since it has the fortune, like the first coal block that I mined, I got six creosote oil out of one block. So it is very, very interesting. It seems to fortune and then auto smelt instead of vice versa. So very, very nice. It doesn't really work with ingots. It's still just one ingot. So fortune does not work with those, even when you have auto smelt. But that's okay. That's fine. It would be really OP though if I was to mine like say iron and get like five iron ingots. It would be amazing. But anyways, that's what our Terra Shatterer has now. So anyways, let's go ahead and oh, by the way, I did make a Stone of Temperance. So if I want a 3x3 with the Terra Shatterer, I can do that by using the Stone of Temperance. Also, I upgraded this to a Gaia Mana Spreader as well. So, but anyways, that's enough rambling. Let's go ahead and jump into what we're going to be doing today, which is working on the Cobbleworks. So first and foremost, I'm going to want a conjuration catalyst. So we're just going to need an alchemy catalyst, which is brewing stands, mana pearl, gold, and living rock. And then in addition, let me see, sand, if I recall, is through the alchemy catalyst. Yes, it is. With through use of cobblestone anyway. So we're actually going to need two alchemy catalysts. I do have one over here. Under what? Oh, we got like a major rubber band effect there. I do have one right underneath this, but that is for personal use. And I'm also going to want a personal use conjuration catalyst. So let's go ahead and just make. I've only got three brings. Okay, I'm just going to go grab. I'll make some new ones. But we're going to want basically to get ourselves three alchemy catalysts to start with. And then we're going to want, what, three mana pearls, 12 living rock. Ooh, living rock. I don't think we have enough of that. Except we do. So there we go. There's three alchemy catalysts. Now, of course, one of these we're going to want to keep as an alchemy catalyst, and then we're going to want two conjuration catalysts. So that's a bunch of living rock. We're going to need a couple pixie dust and some elementium, which I've got the pixie dust. That's not a problem. Elementium, we're going to need what? 8 mana steel for that? No, we're going to need 12 mana steel for that. By the way, I'm on the server right now with Grok, Link, and Relic. So they've been hanging out. Stalker was on here, but he just got off like just a minute ago. All right, so we've got our extra conjuration catalyst. For right now, I'm just going to throw this in here. I'm not going to set that up right this second, but we will fairly soon. But anyways, we'll get a couple mana pools. I'm going to grab this. I don't know if I'm going to use the Dominant Spark yet. I'm kind of just winging it at the moment. And then I'm also going to want just a couple open crates. Then I'm also going to want a couple redstone torches, a bit of redstone, and then I'm going to need a couple hoppers. I want to say that we've got hoppers down here, but I could be wrong. And I may actually need some hopper ducks as well. I'm not for sure. But the first thing that we're going to be automating today is going to be gravel. So let me grab a storage drawer. And then we're also going to want an upgrade. And it's going to be the redstone upgrade, which is just redstone. And then the do we have any upgrade templates on hand? We do not. Okay, let me go grab some sticks. Then we'll go ahead and just grab two redstone upgrades for now. That will be fine. And I know my inventory is already shot, but we're about to use up some of this stuff. So anyways, also let me grab some gravel just so I can set up this chest. All right, so right here is where we're going to put gravel. That's great. And then what we're going to do is we're going to give this a redstone upgrade. Just like that. All good. And you can see that right now we have a redstone power of one. So, which what I'm going to do, I think, is the gravel chest, it's not going to stay completely filled. But once we put some storage upgrades in there, of course, once that storage threshold is a bit higher, we'll have plenty of gravel in there. And so I'm not terribly concerned about it. it'll be more than enough. Let's just put it that way. But what we'll do is we'll set up our conjuration catalyst. We'll put it, we're going to put our conjuration catalyst right here. Yeah, that's where I want it. And then what we'll do is, let's see, we'll put our mana pool down right there. And then above that, we're going to put a spark. And so that's going to start getting some mana in it, which is great. And then above that, we'll put our open crate, which apparently an open crate can go. Like the spark can be inside the open crate. How interesting. Oh, very, very interesting. I never knew that. So you can see it's still getting mana. Yeah, it's still the mana's still going up in it. So I'm gonna leave it alone. Honestly, I mean, that's fine. A little bit more compact that way anyway. And then we're gonna set up a hopper, and I guess we're just gonna put the hopper right here. Right there, and then we will. Let's see, do I have any more of this metamorphic mesa stone? I want to say I do not. Let me check. I've got to get that stuff automated, that metamorphic stone. No, I do not. So for the time being, we're just going to use living rock bricks, which really isn't that bad, honestly. And what we'll do is we'll set this up like right there, and then we're gonna have our, yeah, we'll have our redstone torch right there, of course, so that this gets locked. So for example, if we throw a piece of cobblestone in there, it's not gonna get pulled out. And then running from this gravel, let's see, what timers do I have? Okay, that's perfect. Couldn't remember if the dark utilities timer could be disabled with a redstone signal, which it can. So that is, ideally, that's what we want. And so what we'll do is we'll set up our timer. We're gonna have it. See, if I was to set it here, I want to say it. No, actually, I know that it doesn't. That it won't disable that redstone torch because I was actually playing around with it in the Direwolf series, I think yesterday. So we'll set up our timer right here, and then we'll have our redstone just kind of come off of that. And there we go. It turns the torch on and off, which is wonderful. That's what we want. And then what I want to do is just kind of run this redstone from here. So you can see, like right now, it's a redstone signal of one. And once this storage builds up, it will be, of course, strong enough to disable that. And I tell you what, we'll just run it back here, actually. But we want to make sure it doesn't touch the Hopper Hawk, because we don't want to disable the Hopper Hawk when it has a redstone signal. Now, if I find that this isn't enough, I can use a comparator, of course, to make it, you know, basically make it require a stronger signal. And so I may do that, but I'm thinking that if I put some emerald upgrades in this, like maybe two, then it would have to have like what, like 100 stacks or something like that to reach this. So that would be fine. I mean, I don't really need more than 100 stacks, but I'm trying to make it fairly compact and kind of fit into this without, you know, needing a whole bunch of excess space and all that mess. And so now what I need to do is let me get some hopper ducks. And I'm kind of curious if we can insert from the bottom. Because if we could insert from the bottom, that would be ideal. But I'm not for sure if that would work with hopper ducks. I want to say it would. But I've got to check. And let's go ahead and lock all of these because I don't want them messing up on me. And so what we're going to do is let's go ahead and come under the ground here. We're going to put a hopper on the bottom of this. And then what we'll do is we'll just have, let's see. We're going to see if this works. Fingers crossed that it does. So we'll just bring our hopper ducks along. Oh, you know what? These won't pull out because it has a redstone upgrade. Gosh. Okay, I tell you what, we're gonna have to use a comparator for this then. Which, I mean, that's fine. It's just a little bit more set up, but that's okay. So what we'll do is we'll have our comparator here. And then we'll have our redstone come out like to there. And then we'll have it connect up like that. And so I will probably have to limit what it takes with a redstone signal. That's fine. Not really an issue. So let me grab a comparator. I can't remember if I've got some made up already or not. Alright, so we'll put our comparator right here. And then let's go ahead and just grab this redstone upgrade out of here. And there we go. It looks like it's draining now. It's going into that, which apparently, yeah, it won't go. It's going into the hopper, which is awesome. That's what I want to happen. But it's not with the open crate down that low, it won't insert. So we are going to have to raise that hopper. So we'll do our open crate up here then, and our hopper right there. So you'll notice the gravel should be building up. All right, so what we're going to do to raise this, I think, is we're just going to set up our redstone torch. I didn't mean to grab that. But we're going to put our redstone torch right here. You'll notice it stops the thing from running. And then what I want to do is, because I mean right now it's going absolutely crazy. It's just beom, 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 beom. We're just going to run this redstone out like that. There we go. And every time it does that, it makes two gravel at the cost of one gravel. So before long, it will get to the point where we're caught up on gravel. So I'm going to set it to 60 ticks. Because you'll notice before we started out with like not nearly this much, but I think we started with one stack and it's already, I mean, jumped quite a bit up. So, and now realistically, I could actually take this timer and move it. And guess what? We are going to do that. In fact, and I could make this kind of come back, I guess. Yeah, we'll do that. And then what I'll do is I'll set the timer up right up here instead. And we'll say 60 ticks. That's 3 seconds. So now let's see, 1, 2, 5. Yeah, I would have to have a redstone signal 5. I mean, that's about a third of the way field. I'm fairly happy with that. But you'll notice we're already up to 3.5 stacks. And once these hoppers back up, then it'll start filling up this drawer and giving us, surplus gravel. So like right now, let's go ahead and just set it to like 20 seconds. That's a bit better. Because I mean, this does have an automatic shutoff, so I'm not too concerned about running it a little bit faster like that. Once every second, I think is good. Because it doesn't use a whole lot of mana to double that gravel. Gravel is a minute thing. So realistically, once this kind of builds up, we'll have infinite gravel, which in turn will also be infinite flint. So that's always handy. Now I don't know that. Okay, yeah, there's not really anything that I want to use that for. I mean, we could always auto craft it into flint or something like that, but I'm not too worried about that right this second. Because eventually we can sag mill it. Right now, I mean, it's 3 flint, or it's 3 gravel for 1 flint, and our uses for gravel are minimal at the moment. So I'm just going to leave it at that. Gravel, if I need flint, I can make flint. Okay, so that's automated. Good stuff. Now, next up, I think we want to get sand, because sand in turn makes glass and clay. So I think what we're going to do is we're going to set up chests or drawers on this side to have sand, clay, and glass in. So let me go grab like a little of each of those so that I can throw them into these drawers just to get them locked in. Okay, I went ahead, I've got sand locked into this one. And then in the next one I have a compacting drawer instead of just a standard drawer that has clay and then clay balls. And then we have glass in this one, and this one we're going to use for bricks, because I think I'm going to go ahead and have bricks automated as well. So the reason I use the compacting drawer is so we can just use a graded hopper, pull out the clay balls, and then smelt them, and then send the bricks over to here. So bricks and glass, I mean, that's easy enough. We'll get those automated as well. And it's a little bit more symmetrical at the moment. And then we can do metamorphic stone along the top. So I think that'll look good. So what we're going to do is actually similar to this side, I think. So we'll go ahead and pull up that. We're going to put down our alchemy catalyst, which I think, I mean, this could be a little bit more centered. Tell you what, we're actually going to put it back here. I think that would look good. So we'll have our alchemy catalyst right behind this one. So we're going to put our open crate right here. Yeah, I mean, that's still dropping and everything, so we should be okay. We'll attach the hopper right there, and we'll put our maniple down right here, and then let's just go ahead and give it a spark. And there we go. It's going to start filling up with mana. All right, so sand will be the first thing that we're going to automate, and I'm not going to use the redstone upgrade on this one either, and that's because we're going to have a hopper that pulls out the sand, because we're going to need it to make clay and glass and all that good stuff. So let's get another comparator. And by the way, I am going to add off switches to these other generators, like basically tie them in somehow. But I'm just waiting right now. And the reason being, the way I'm going to do that is if hourglasses receive a mana pulse, they will stop running. And then if they receive another mana pulse, they'll start back up. So I may end up doing something with that, perhaps, to shut these off. Honestly, I may just do it a manual shut off for these, because like I'm trying to build this fairly compact, and at the moment having to actually use redstone and stuff like that instead of having some kind of more compact form like redstone conduits or something like that that's a little bit easier to run and maneuver around, it's very hard to do much redstone when having something that's fairly compact like this. I just want all the cobble works to be in this section, so it does make it a little bit difficult at times, but we'll have our comparator right here. And then let's go ahead and we'll have our redstone come out pretty much the same way as that one is. Then we'll have something like that, I do believe. And then we'll have our redstone torch right here. And I am going to put just a torch on the other side just so this is all lit up. And then we'll have our redstone run up to like right here. And then I'm going to have a timer on this side. So basically that's going to be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 that the sand will have to be filled up before it'll shut off and stop that from running. So then let's get a timer. And I know I'm having to like do a little bit of cutting and stuff while I'm explaining it. So I hope you guys are following along okay, and it's not too hard to figure out what I'm doing. Because I will say I'm kind of winging it. So, hope you guys don't mind too much. I just figured we kind of just jump in here and just roll with it, so to speak. So let's get our timer, and we'll say 20 ticks on this one as well. There we go. Yeah, we did get 2 sand in that, which is awesome. That's what I wanted to happen. And so now what I want to do is I don't know if I want to do a slave or just do hopper ducks. I think I'm just going to do hopper ducks, which I am going to need to make a few more of these. All right, so there's 15. That may be enough. And then let's grab some frame trim just because I do want to connect all these up. And so what we're going to do is, I guess the trim, I think we should be fine connecting it just straight into the clay or the bricks line. All right, so now that's plugged up. And then what I want to do is underneath the cobblestone, I just want to set up a hopper Which honestly, this is going to be a whole lot easier once we get blood magic. I really need to get cracking on that, I think, but we'll get to it. I promise. All right, so we'll just bring our hopper ducks. So there's our hopper that we need to connect into. And so we're just going to run these on back and plug them in. Just like that. All right, so now if we pop out of here, yeah, we're getting sand. 7, 8, 9, and so on. So that's going to run until, of course, this builds up enough charge to send that to the timer. So now we have sand and gravel automated, and so those are going to start building up, and it gives us a nice use for all the cobblestone that we've been creating, because it is going to be using up a bit of that cobblestone to make this stuff. So awesome. That is now in place. And so now that that's done, the next thing that we need to automate is glass and clay. So let's go ahead and we're going to start with glass, I think. Or no, we'll start with clay first, I think. So what we're going to need for that is, of course, a Clayconia, which is 2 light gray, a cyan, and a rune of earth. And earth is mushroom, coal, and stone. All right, and we're also going to need a Rannan Carpus, of course. Those are like pretty much standard fare at this point, for anything, you know, that requires placing blocks and whatnot. And then we're going to want an open crate. There we go. And let's see, what's the range on our Hopper Hawk? Okay, it covers out to right in here. So I tell you what, we're going to set this up so that it'll work within this area. So we can keep using the same, you know, the same Hopper Hawk. Because I really don't need the full Clayconia area that it can cover. By the way, we're already up to 3.5 stacks of sand. So we'll be set on sand. You know what? The comparator may not work with the drawer unless you give it a redstone upgrade, which is, I mean, I can work around it because I can use controller slaves with graded hoppers to pull the items out of the system. I wish it was side-based and not just the whole thing just emits redstone. Well, anyways, let's go ahead and set this up. So basically, we're going to pull out sand. And so I think what we're going to do is we're going to have our Rannan Carpus just right here. That would be fine. Above it, we'll have our open crate. Yeah, right there will be our open crate. I think it should drop onto the Rannan Carpus with no problem. I may have to raise it. We'll see. We'll see how it goes. And so what we're going to do is we'll just have our hopper right here to grab sand. And then for right now, underneath the Rannan Carpus, we'll just do a living rock. No, actually, no. Not a living rock brick, because there's living rock all over the place. It'll try to put things everywhere. Let's see. Do I have some more of that that one block that we cooked up? Or no, I don't want to use the same block. They shouldn't reach. It shouldn't be a problem, but we'll do something else. Let's do pavers, hardened stone pavers. So what I'm thinking is we'll do like 6. And let's see, what's the Clayconia's range? Because I'm thinking we'll have the Clayconia right here. And okay, it's got plenty of range. Plenty of range. That's perfect. So what we're going to do is we're going to just remove all of this. And we'll do hardened stone pavers right through here. Basically 6 of these. That should be plenty of space, which it is. I'll tell you what, I'm going to do it off in this direction, actually. And then we'll do, yeah, we need a hardened stone paver right here. underneath our Rannan carpus. And so now if sand gets dropped, it's going to get placed on these hardened stone pavers. And then I just need to plug this open crate up. And so I'm thinking, let's get some more hopper ducts. And then we'll just have our hopper right here that's going to accept the stuff. And then, of course, we're going to bring this out. Put a redstone torch on here, which this one, it's just going to have a timer. We're not going to have to worry about, you know, it actually needing a shutoff. That's not going to be a problem. So we're just going to have a redstone, piece of redstone right there, and then we'll have an hourglass. So we'll just put our hovering hourglass right here, and then let's just run our hopper ducts on over just like that. There's like hopper duct wiring all over the place, which I'm going to wait to pull that or to connect that, because I want to, let's see, how much sand do we want in this hourglass? We'll say like 6. Okay. So now, we'll connect that up. This is getting sand. Then it should start dropping that to the Rannan carpus. Okay, you know what? We need maybe infestation spores. And then if we, I think it's if we right click it with the infestation spores. Yeah. Okay. So now it's a hopper hawk that's been infested. I've got to figure out something with these shaders. I know I've been saying that. I've been looking, but I do tend to get sidetracked. So I'll try to figure something out. But anyways, so that's working correctly now. But anyways, we're building up sand. That's wonderful. Once this gets built up, I do need that buffer kind of field, but then it'll actually start going into this furnace. And what we're going to do is we're just going to set ourselves up 3 of these exoflames, like what we have over here. So let me get those really, really quick. And then what we're going to do is we're going to set up our double chest just right up here. And then we're going to have our hopper ducts, instead of actually plugging up, oh man, okay, we're going to have our hopper ducts actually plug into the back of this chest, just like that. I may adjust it later on, but I'm not too worried about the hopper ducts, because before long, we're going to change everything over into blood magic conduits, once we have access to that. So anyways, this chest is going to fill up, that's fine, I'm not concerned about that. If I was, I could put, you know, a bunch of cobblestone in here, and then just have a grated hopper to only accept sand on both of these. So it's still going to pull stuff out of here with the hopper. And then I want another hopper that actually feeds into a furnace. And we'll have the furnace just right here. That's great. And then we'll put our hopper right here. And so this should start. Okay. I want to make sure that this wood feed into these other slots. It does. It's just we don't have enough sand right now. So I'm actually going to speed this up. We're going to turn this one to 20 ticks. The gravel one can be a bit slower. I don't mind. But the sand one's going to be getting so much use that I need it to be fast. I really do. All right. I went ahead and broke off the gravel for right now, because like right now we have 15 and a half stacks of gravel. Realistically, that's plenty for the time being. And this is starting to get built up. It's going to take a little while for that much sand to build up. I'm making 1 per second, and of course it's making clay and stuff as well. We're up to 30 blocks of clay, though. And honestly, we can shut this whole system off by just having a redstone signal go to the Rannan carpus. Of course, without the comparators working, I've got to figure out something. Like I said, once we get the blood magic stuff, we'll be set. That'll fix all of our problems. So, but anyways, our furnace is set up. It's ready to cook clay, or cook sand and make glass. And so then what we'll do is we'll just have So I didn't mean to throw that down. Give it back. We will just have... Why is it dropping everything that I go to grab? I don't understand what that's about. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to have the glass is basically just going to have hopper ducts here. And there's the hopper. And so glass is going to get pulled out and go into this. And then what we're going to do is we're going to set up our exoflame. Why is it doing that? Yeah, anything I go to move around in my inventory, it just chucks it on the ground. Okay, it's fixed now. It was something to do with Alt getting stuck, apparently, according to Google. And so I just had to get that sorted out. But anyways, we're going to put down a few exoflames. So I think what we're going to do is we're going to put them just right... We'll just line them up right here. And let's see. Do they have... Okay, this one down here does not have a mana pool. Okay. So what we're going to do, actually, is let's just set up a mana pool. Because I'm going to need one anyway. Shortly for Metamorphic Stone and stuff like that. Not this episode. Because I know this episode's getting a bit long. We're nearly done. I do apologize. Like I said, I was kind of winging it. And I think it turned out all right. I think we did fine. Some of the stuff took a second to figure out what we were going to do with it. But what we'll do is we'll have, I think, a mana pool right here. And we'll just give it a spark. I don't know if that's going to be able to... Yeah, it should. Should receive mana. But let's go ahead and give it a dominant augment. Just because I think it's too far to reach the recessive one. There we go. That's going to start building up from all the other mana pools. Good stuff. And then what I want to do is I just want to bind our flowers to this. Like that. And then we'll also go ahead and bind our Clayconia to this mana pool as well. And the Ranin Carpus. Okay. So everything's bound to this mana pool now, and this furnace, if it receives sand, there we go, it's going to cook it up and create glass for us. So this will start building up glass. That's awesome. We've got clay, we've got sand, everything is good. And so now the last thing that we need to do is we need to actually set this up to smelt clay blocks. And so that way we can get our bricks so that we have that kind of stuff on hand. So we'll go ahead and set up another furnace right here. And this one is going to take clay balls and cook them up. I want to go ahead and grab one just so that we can make ourselves a brick, put it into here. And then what we'll do is let's get a couple hoppers. I'm going to need one graded hopper and one standard hopper. All right, so our graded hopper, we'll just go ahead and set it up right there. And we're going to say, you can only use clay balls. Now granted, we could use controller slaves. I don't know, I may end up removing some of the hopper ducts around here with controller slaves, but we'll see. I haven't decided yet what I want to do. But anyways, we just need to run this over to the furnace. And we'll just plug it straight in. We don't need hoppers and all that to plug it in. So we'll just run this down. Okay, actually I think we have to plug it into the top, don't we? There we go. Now it's cooking. Now we're cooking with fire. Alright, so that's going to start cooking up bricks, and then all we have to do here is then just pull it out with the hopper, and we're going to plug it in. Let me actually set this stuff here. We're going to pull it out with the hopper and pipe it over in that direction. I may have to make a couple more hopper ducts, but we're pretty well set. No, actually, we've got plenty of hopper ducts. And we'll just plug this. And there we go. Okay, so now it's making bricks and it's pumping those bricks into here. So it will take, of course, it's going to take a little bit for this to build up because we need sand built up and all that good stuff. I mean, gravel, we've got a bunch of it. I'll probably add some storage upgrades, and once this stuff gets kind of built up on mana, because you'll notice that mana is a little bit low at the moment. But I will focus a bit more mana over here. I'll probably put a potency lens on the Gaia spreader so we can get a little bit mana, a little bit more mana over here a little bit quicker. Because this area does use a lot of mana, as you can tell. But it's fairly compact. I mean, you look at this and it's, you know, there's room for improvement because we could use blood magic conduits, we could use different things like that and make this a whole lot more compact. But at the moment, it's fairly good. Now I will have to sort out this comparator issue, but I may just wait until we have the blood magic conduits. Then I can use the redstone upgrade, have the blood magic conduits pulling and moving items from these storage drawers. Or realistically, I could just have slaves and have them filtered, you know, with the, from the slave or the drawer controller or something like that. That would be fine too. And then have the redstone upgrades in these that need them. The only thing is I don't know if it's going to affect the ones next to it. I may have to do some organizing and stuff. I don't know why these comparators don't work. But the Ranin Carpus, it can just receive a redstone signal. It'll stop running, and then this will, you know, this will work fine. But yeah, so I mean that's pretty much it. I mean, we've got all this stuff running anyways and creating these things for us. And we'll let the sand build up, and we should see, you know, that get all sorted. And then once this fills up with bricks, I'm probably going to leave the stack limit at 32. I may eventually upgrade it. But once this builds up, then this clay will back up. So eventually we'll just have, you know, normal clay and everything. So, but anyways, I hope that wasn't too jumping around for you guys. I tried to get it all sorted out as best I could. I know I was kind of jumping around. Like I said, I really winged this, cause I figured we'd just hop in here and have some fun and get it all set up and everything. But, yeah, I'm fairly happy with it cause it is very compact. I do quite enjoy this, and it's going to be really, really nice moving forward because a lot of this stuff, of course, is no fun to have to farm, like clay and sand and stuff like that. I hate farming it. I hate always having to cook up glass and all of that. So, and this should be making, this will start making glass fairly soon, honestly. So that'll be good. But yeah, so anyways, if you guys have any questions, as always, let me know and I will do my best to get those answered for you. But it is about wrapping up point. So I hope you guys enjoyed the episode, and yeah, I'm very happy with this. I'm very, very happy with this. The only other thing that I really want to add to this area is I do want to do living wood. We need to get that set up, and then I also want to set up metamorphic stone. And then as we progress, we'll clean this up and condense it once we get access to things like the blood magic conduits and thing and, you know, whatnot. We will make some changes to this going forward, and we'll probably add some just shut-off switches and stuff. We might even do like a full shut-off switch that basically shuts off everything with a single switch. I don't know. We might be able to pull that off. I'll have to see. But yeah, so anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed it. And if you did, as always, be sure and hit that like button. And go ahead and subscribe if you're not already for more daily videos. And next episode, we're probably going to be working with blood magic a bit. Because I do want to start, you know, really working towards getting those conduits unlocked more than anything. Because we'll be able to make some major upgrades to the base once that time comes. So, but anyways, until next time, as always, do take care and stay safe. And I do apologize, there was not a stream yesterday. Our power actually went out. We've been having some major storms, lightning storms, tornadoes. We had a hail storm the other day. Like, it's just the season for storming. But anyways, it stormed, the power went out, and then I fell asleep waiting for the power to come back on. So that's why there was not a stream yesterday. But anyways, until next time, do take care, stay safe, and I will see you guys then.